friend, the last time we made friends, we were looking at types of matrices, and we said a square matrix is that matrix that has the same number of rows and same number of columns, e.g., if I have a matrix A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and I, this matrix I have on the board has 1, 2, 3 rows and 1, 2, 3 rows. So, such type of matrix which has equal number of rows and columns is what we call a square matrix. We continue and look at what we call a rectangular matrix. Now, a rectangular matrix will be that matrix that has different an equal number of rows and columns. A rectangular matrix will be that matrix that has an equal number of rows and columns. For example, if I have a matrix with elements A, B, C, D, E, F, this matrix has two rows by three columns. Because they are unequal in number, then we are going to refer to it as a rectangular matrix. Another type could be A, B, C. This matrix has only one row by one, two, three columns. It could be a rectangular matrix, but we are going to give it a special name, and it is going to be called a row matrix. This rectangular matrix has a special name, which we are calling a row matrix. Reason, it has only one row. The next category is going to be a column matrix, and this matrix is of this type, A, B, C. This matrix has 1, 2, 3 rows by one column. This category could also be called a rectangular matrix, but with a special name, column matrix. So those are the type of matrices we shall look at today. After that, we want to look at how we can add and subtract matrices. Friends, I want you to note that the order of a matrix is very important in addition and subtraction of matrices. The order of a matrix is very important when you're going to add or subtract matrices. If I have a matrix A which has 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 as its elements, I have another matrix B with elements 1, 4, 3, 2, 4, and 7. We are going to look at, can I add this matrix to this? We are saying the additions can be done after ascertaining the order of the two matrices given. So if I'm finding A plus B, I am supposed to write these ones down, 2, 4, 3, 5, 6, 7, plus, I'm now substituting in this, plus 1, 2, 4, 4, 3, 7. This is number, I'm substitution. I'm substituting where there is A, I'm putting matrix A plus matrix B, which is that. So we now go ahead and look at compatibility. Compatibility will come by looking at the order of the matrices given to us. The order of this matrix, which is matrix A, is 2 by 3. 2 by 3, and this one is also 2 by 3. When the orders of the matrices we are adding are the same, then we can add the two matrices. If the orders are different, we can never add. So because these are the same, we add the elements, the corresponding elements. When I talk of corresponding, this corresponds with this, this corresponds with that, and that corresponds with that. This corresponds with this, this with this, and that with that. So we shall have our A plus B is 2 plus 1, which is 3, 3 plus 4, which is 7, 6 plus 3, which is 9, 4 plus 2, which is 6, 5 plus 4, which is 9, and 7 plus 7, which is 14. This is called the resultant matrix. We have got from A plus B. It must also have the same order as the matrices we have, which is 2 by 3. The same will apply to subtraction. If I'm just going for, because of time, I'm just going to use the same matrices I have. I am now looking at, I'm given matrix A as that, matrix B as that. I'm now looking for A minus B. So I'm substituting, this one becomes a minus. And for us to subtract, also the orders must be the same. We can only subtract two matrices when their orders are the same. Corresponding elements are subtracted. So I have 2 minus 1, which is a 1, 3 minus 4, which is negative 1, 6 minus this, which is a 3, 4 minus 2, which is a 2, 5 minus 4, which is a 1, and 7 minus 7, which is a 0. So the order still remains 2 by 3. And this is the matrix we get by subtracting A minus B. So in summary, we can only subtract or add when the order of the matrices are the same and we subtract the corresponding elements. Two, the order of the answer or the resultant matrix we get must also remain the same. I go to the next step, which is multiplication by a scalar. Multiplication by a scalar means I have a matrix A, which is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These are elements in that matrix A. Someone is going to tell you, if I have A plus A plus A plus A, what do I get? Under normal circumstances, we are supposed to be adding this value by substitution. I put this one here, this one there, I continuously repeat. But in summary, instead of doing all that, you just add this plus this plus this plus this, and you get 4A. They've told me I have a matrix A, which is that. They are telling me to find 4A. When I add these ones, I get 4A. So the meaning is, this 4 is called the scalar. 4A means 4 into, 4 multiplied into the value of A, which is that, 3, 6, 4, 7, 5, 8. This value which is outside is referred to as a scalar. And what do we do to the scalar? The scalar is multiplied to every value inside the, every element inside the matrix. So for us to get 4A, we shall have 4 by 3, which is 12, 4 4 by this which is 16, 4 by that which is a 20, and 4 by this which is 24, this by this which is 28, and this is 36. This is the same as a plus, so the summary is this, and this is what you get. This value, you just multiply everything, you'll get that. That marks the end of our next portion. We wait for the third one. Thank you.